When you think of cholesterol, you probably think of bad or high cholesterol. But there's also a good type of cholesterol that your body needs. Cholesterol is a waxy substance that's found in all of your cells and has several useful functions, including helping to build your body's cells. It's carried through your bloodstream attached to proteins. These proteins are called lipoproteins. High-density lipoprotein, HDL, is the good kind of cholesterol and the kind you want. Low-density lipoprotein, LDL, is the bad kind of cholesterol and the kind you want to keep in check. HDL, LDL, and triglycerides, a type of fat carried in the blood, make up total cholesterol levels. HDL is like a vacuum cleaner for cholesterol in the body. When it's at healthy levels in your blood, it removes extra cholesterol and plaque buildup in your arteries and then sends it to your liver. Your liver expels it from your body. Ultimately, this helps reduce your risk of heart disease, heart attack, and stroke. An ideal HDL level trusted source is 60 mg or deciliter or above. Your HDL is considered low if it's below 40 mg or deciliter. You should aim to have an HDL level between 40 and 60 mg or deciliter, but over 60 mg or deciliter is optimal. Here are the tips to boost your good or HDL cholesterol. Exercise regularly. An analysis in the Archives of Internal Medicine found that moderate intensity aerobic exercise, for example, walking, cycling or continuous swimming for at least 15 minutes, consistently increases HDL levels. Stop smoking. Smoking increases the risk of many health problems, including heart disease and lung cancer. One of its negative effects is a suppression of HDL cholesterol. In a one-year study of more than 1,500 people, those who quit smoking had twice the increase in HDL as those who resumed smoking within the year. The number of large HDL particles also increased, which further reduced heart disease risk. Lose weight. If you're overweight, losing just 10 pounds can increase your HDL. The goal is to achieve a healthy body mass index, BMI, of between 18.5 and 25. If you lose weight, do it steadily over time through healthy eating and regular exercise. Eat fatty fish often. The omega-3 fats in fatty fish provide major benefits to heart health, including a reduction in inflammation and better functioning of the cells that line your arteries. Limit processed foods. The average American diet is rife with processed foods, which contain high amounts of trans and saturated fats. When consumed in excess, trans and saturated fats have a negative effect on cholesterol levels. Trans fats in particular have been shown to lower HDL levels. Add fiber to your diet. The soluble fiber found in fruits, vegetables, nuts, legumes, and grains may boost HDL levels, as well as help lower your total cholesterol. Reduce sugar intake. The carbohydrates found in sweet comfort foods, like ice cream, cookies, and highly refined desserts, can lower HDL and raise your levels of triglycerides, another type of cholesterol in your blood. Choose healthier fats. Minimize the saturated fats, like butter, lard, and full-fat dairy, and trans fats, found in many processed foods and snacks, in your diet. Instead, switch to products containing unsaturated fats, which are found in plant-derived oils like olive, canola, and flaxseed oils. Thanks for watching the video. Comments below. Don't forget to like the video, share with your friends, and subscribe.